Was down by Bredigan's corner one morning I did stray. I met a fellow rebel, and to me he did say, "We've orders from the captain to assemble at Dunbar, but how are we to get there without a motor car?" Oh, Barney, dear, be of good cheer, I tell you what we'll do. The specials, they are plentiful, the IRA are few. We'll send a wire to Johnson to meet us at Stranraer, and we'll give the boys a bloody good ride in Johnson's motor car. When Dr. Johnson heard the news, he soon put on his shoes. He says, "This is an urgent case, there is no time to lose." He then put on his castor head and on his breast a star. You could hear the din all through Glenfinn of Johnston's motor car. But when he got to the railway bridge, some rebels he saw there. Oh, Johnson knew the game was up, for at him they did stare. He said, "I have a permit to travel near and far. To hell with your English permit, we want your motor car." What will my local brethren think when they hear of the news? My car, it has been commandeered by the rebels at Dunluce. We'll give you a receipt for it, all signed by Captain Barr. And when Ireland gets her freedom, boy, you'll get your motor car. Well, we put the car in motion and filled it to the brim. With guns and bayonets as shining made old Johnson grin. And Barney hoisted a Sinn Féin flag and it fluttered like a star. And we gave three cheers for the IRA and Johnston's motor car. And we gave three cheers for the IRA and Johnston's motor car.